This is a demonstration how to get an elevation surface from some data we have here in a spreadsheet. The coordinates, and I have copy and pasted this data into a point cloud text file. I have to substitute the comma by a point to get the right format, and I have stored it with the name row.asc. Okay. Now we need the current version of the geodata. I have checked in the elevation grid script into this workbench. So geodata elevation grid, the last point. Then a dialog opens and we use this data set. Okay, now we have a dialog and we can start first. We have different models which are implemented in SkiPy library. We start with the linear model. We say the Z scale factor should be 1, and we want to see the matplot picture of our interpolation, and we run the script. So now we have here the figure, and when I have to close this matplotlib window, and now I have here the 3D model, and there is the other points, the starting points. I hide the rest. Oh, not good to see, so we change the color dark blue. So this is the point set. Then we have here next the interpolated points. Once more, and here is the calculated grid, and this is still the same with a colored surface, so I can see where here are the height and the lower point. Okay, we can change the model, so we can use thin plate. I think thin plate is often the best choose. To see a little bit more, I change the Z factor, or I let it stay. So we have now a different model. We can do a cubic interpolation. Then we have this. This is the problem, that the cubic interpolation now at this point here goes down, because I do not have in this area measure points. And you can play with any kind of interpolation. And what we see is that some of these special formats are not very useful, so I say quintic is in most cases not a good way, but linear, thin plate, and cubic are always good interpolation methods.